Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Amy and I'm on a journey to becoming more fit and more healthy, and right now I'm on a journey to learn how to belly dance. And I've done two other videos on this now and I want to do a third one, and I've been practicing a little bit but not really, and so I just thought I really need to start practicing more or I'll never learn. And then eventually I'll start doing like belly dancing workout videos. And yeah, so without further ado, I'm just going to hop on to like where I kind of left off and refresh my memory. I'm almost towards like the end of the lessons videos. Then I'm going to jump all the way back to the beginning and try and do them all, and then work on them like kind of individually, I suppose. So yeah, let's get in. So what I'm working on right now is mostly hips, and I do think that when I'm learning them better, getting them better individually, I do want to like focus on getting the hips down first, because I don't know, they're more fun, I guess. And then I'll move on to doing like chest, and then I think I'm pretty good with like that movement. I mean, obviously there's always more room, but without further ado. Okay, so I've been practicing a little bit with the hips, and I decided that I was going to focus like maybe on like two or something, and then get perfected or something on that. And I got a comment on my last video that said if you put like a rock or a jewel or something in your belly button and it doesn't fall out, then like you like mastered the isolation or something like that. I don't know. So I'm gonna practice some of these, and then when I feel like I'm getting them, I'm gonna put a jewel in. And then if I can do it without it falling out, then I'll move on to the next couple ones. So right now I am just doing the hip lifts and basic shimmy. So I'll show you what that looks like on me, at least.
Isolation. Let's try that with music. Make sure you're not moving in space so your head's not bumping up and down. And faster. And full speed.
That makes your legs so sore, and I am sweating so bad. This is a workout, man. Anyways, that is my hip dip. So I'm gonna go rewatch what I just did to see if it even looked remotely like a hip dip. Okay, it kind of looks sloppy. I don't know if I'm keeping my head still. Like, I can't tell, so I'm gonna practice balancing cup on my head, and then I'm going to practice doing that with balancing the cup on my head. And then let's see if I actually keep my upper body still. All right, I got this. I think I found my spot. Alrighty. I think I'm ready to practice with this on my head. Hold these down.
A little bit faster.
instantly fell. Okay.
Let go. Up and up and up and up. And the closer you are to the ground, the easier it will be for you to find that isolation. Let's try that with music. A little bit faster. Keeping the heels on the floor, chest floating up, arms relaxed. Make sure you're not moving in space so your head's not bumping up and down.
Okay, I need to find the center. Here.
And that's the basic hip isolation.
I don't know. I do want to see if that kind of...
Los Latinos.
I do want to see if that kind of helped the looks or made it worse. So I'm going to go back and watch. Okay, so we're going to try that one more time. So, yeah.
Isolation. Let's try that with music. A little bit faster. Keeping the heels on the floor, chest floating up, arms relaxed. Make sure you're not moving in space so your head's not bopping up and down. And faster.
No!
And full speed.
That's so hard.
And that's the basic hip isolation.
You've evolved.
So should your snacks.
I don't know if that looked right
to me. Beyond meat jerky.
This is where I use what...
I hate commercials. Okay. It's like sliding. I feel like part of it's your hair, because, you know, your hair's gonna move. Okay. Oh, it's break time. Okay, so I think there was improvement there, so... After my break, I'm going to go on to practice the next one, which will be hip slides. So, and then I think I'm going to try and just do two per video. Let me see how many like hip ones there are. 36 of them, I believe. So, I don't know. I'm just going to do a couple for this one, I guess. Because I feel like, ooh. I feel like if I just throw in like six different moves in one, that's I'm gonna be like dying. So I'm gonna start with just two for this one, and then why stop going out of focus? Two for just this one video, and then if I am able to add more, then I will. But I need a break first, so. Okay, lovelies. Now that I've had a break and a slight nap. I am going to move on to the second one I'm going to learn. Practice, that is hip slides. So let's see if that one's like easy, because if it is easier, then I'm going to do like a third one. But if it's like still really hard, then I'm just gonna do these two today.
Lifted, tailbone tucked under, lower abs engaged. We're gonna slide from side to side. Chest lifted, make sure you're still breathing, and you're gonna shift your weight out to one side, keeping the chest in exactly the same position. And then you're gonna shift your weight out to the other side. What you want to try to do is keep the line of your hip scarf or your pants completely horizontal to the floor no matter what, so there's no lifts and no drops. Sliding from side to side. Chest is hovering and is lifted, and you're still breathing. And let's try that with music. Make sure your knees are still bent and your lower abs are engaged. A little bit faster. And if you're comfortable here, add the arms. And that's how you isolate your hips. So now we're going to isolate our. So now we're going to isolate our hips. Let's assume the basic Gagan's posture position.
I'm gonna do facing you.
Knees are bent.
See if it doesn't.
Feet are hip width apart. Chest is lifted. Tailbone tucked under, lower abs engaged. We're gonna slide from side to side. Chest lifted, make sure you're still breathing, and you're gonna shift your weight out to one side, keeping the chest in exactly the same position. And then you're gonna shift your weight out to the other side. What you want to try to do is keep the line of your hip scarf or your pants completely horizontal to the floor no matter what, so there's no lifts and no drops. Sliding from side to side. Chest is hovering and is lifted. And you're still breathing. And let's try that with music. Make sure your knees are still bent and your lower abs are engaged. A little bit faster. And if you're comfortable here, add the arms. And that's how you isolate your hips.
Non-dairy chocolate beyond.
I hate commercials. So I'm going to rewatch that, and then I'll let you know if I'm going to do a third one or not. Okay, so I don't think that was like too bad, so I think I'm gonna do a third one, and then I'm gonna do all three of the ones that like I worked on, and then that will be it for this one, and then the next video will be like three or four more. So, but I will still be keep practicing on these ones quite a bit. Hip twists, I'm doing. So that was.
So now we're going to.
Okay, so I did hip. What did I do? I did. Come on. Okay. Ooh, excuse me. I did hip lifts, basic shimmy. I just did the hip slides, and now it's hip twists.
Slide our hips, going front to back. Let's assume the basic belly dance posture position. Knees are bent, chest is lifted. Make sure the lower abs are engaged. And now you're going to attempt to slide your hips going forward to back. Sliding the right hip, twisting it all the way front, but keeping the chest completely neutral. And now you're going to reverse it and slide back. And again, coming forward and back. Let's try that with music. Make sure the knees are staying slightly bent. The hands are staying really still. Chin is lifted.
This is twisting.
And faster. And once again, it's a completely horizontal movement. There is no lift. And try it full speed.
Okay, I feel like I need to lower the camera because you can't really see, so I'm gonna start that over, but like with it lowered. Okay, yeah, I think that's better. So, fold this up so you can see my stomach.
Back. And again, coming forward. And back. Let's try that with music. Make sure the knees are staying slightly bent. The hands are staying really still. Chin is lifted. And faster. And once again, it's a completely horizontal movement. There is no lift. And try it full speed.
I can't do it without moving my shoulders.
Collect alt.
I'm gonna practice in the mirror. Okay, her feet are like together. I wish I had something for like, hold on. Okay, so I put a belt on hoping that'll give me like that jingling illusion so I can just like see or feel if I'm doing it right, because it just looks weird without like the scarf thingies. So this is my little belt that I've had since a while, and it doesn't jingle a lot, but I'm gonna try. So it doesn't fit me anymore. I don't know. I like it so much and I can't seem to get rid of it quite yet, so. Okay, tell me if that helps. I need to back up or something. Does it look like I'm doing anything, or does it look like I'm just, I don't know. No, that one needs a lot of practice because I cannot do that. Why can't I do that? Am I trying to go too fast? I'm not bad at it slow. Except my shoulders keep moving. All right, let's practice the other ones and then the other two. All right, I had to think about what they even were. I really need to find a good outfit to practice this in. That seemed good. All right, let's try. See, it doesn't seem like that bad. Now let me try the other. Last one. Oh, ow. Alrighty, guys. So I think that's good for right now. I'm gonna keep this in here just for this purpose. So, I think that was going to be enough practicing for right now, and then I will be continuing practicing those, which every time I try and learn a new one, I'll be doing those three first, and then adding a new one. Oh, I'm sweating so bad. So yeah, anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I can get a lot better. And compared to my last video, I don't know. Let me know if you think I've gotten a little bit better at some of these. I don't remember if any of these ones were in the last video. I can't remember. But anyways, thank you so much for watching. If you are new here, please give this video a like and a subscribe. We do fun workout content on this channel, so if that's some stuff that you enjoy watching, like Chloe Ting videos and dance videos and food videos, this is the channel for you. Just come subscribe, click the notification bell. Wow, notification bell every single time I post. I post 2 to 3 times a week. So yeah, and if you watch my videos but have not yet subscribed, what are you doing? Come subscribe and join my channel because I love to have you guys here. And not to mention, I've hit 132 subscribers. That is awesome. Thank you so much, you guys. And even though some other big YouTubers might be like, that's not a lot, that is fantastic. And I am so thankful for every single one of you guys and every single person that watches the videos. Thank you so much. And with that being said, that's the saying. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.